Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you installation of Oracle 21c on Windows machine. So let's start the video. Okay, so you can open any of your browser and just search for Oracle Express Edition download. Okay, so here you can see it is showing me official website, that is oracle.com. You can click on this link, Oracle Database Express Edition download. Now it has redirected me to this download page, and here it is showing me Oracle Database 21c Express Edition. And depending on your operating system, you can select the appropriate download. So I'm just going to install it for Windows 64-bit machine. So I'm going to select this option. Okay, you can see it has started downloading this zip file. It is around 1.8 GB, so it will take time. So we'll wait. Okay, so my download is done. Now I'm going to just extract this downloaded zip file. So I'm just going to my downloads location, and here I'm just going to click on extract all. If you have WinRAR, you can extract with that. And here you can see my extraction process has been started. Okay, so now my extraction is done. I will just go to this extracted file location, and here I'm going to click on the setup application. So just click on this application, and you can see it has started a wizard preparing to install. And now here it is showing me screen, welcome to installation wizard for Oracle 21c Express Edition. So I'm just going to click on this next button, and here is the page for license and agreement. So I have to click on I accept the terms and agreement, and then click on the button next. Now here it is showing me destination folder. So my Oracle Express will be installed in C drive, app, admin, which is nothing but my user, and product 21c. If you wish to change, you can click on this change button. I'm selecting the default location, and then I'm going to click on this next button. Okay, so now here it is showing me provide the password for sys system or pdb admin. So these are the default users which are available for Oracle 21c. So I'm providing a password for sys or system. I'm giving password as system. I will be using simple password. You can provide any password, and then click on next button. And here now it is showing me the different locations or the summary. So this will be the destination folder, and this is going to be Oracle home folder, and this is Oracle base folder. Now I'll click on install button to complete my installation. Okay, my installation has been started. We will wait to complete this process. Here it is showing me Windows Defender Firewall. It is blocking my this application to run. So what I'll do, I'll click on this allow access button so that my installation can get completed. So let me click on this allow access button. Okay, so now here you can see we are getting message configuring Oracle XE database component. So this process will take while, so we have to wait for that. Okay, so the configuration of the product is done. It is showing me Oracle database installed successfully, and here it is showing me few of the connection information. Please take screenshot of this information and store it or save it somewhere. Of course, if you want to access Enterprise Manager or pluggable database or multi-tenant container, then you have to use all this information. So please save this screenshot somewhere. Now I will be clicking on finish button. You can just type SQL plus and just click on this application. See, it is asking me username, so I'm going to provide username as system, and then providing password also. So after providing password, just hit on enter button, and now here you can see it is showing me login successful, and it is showing me connected to Oracle Database 21c Express Edition. Okay, now I will be showing you few of the commands for creating table, for inserting value to table. So let's quickly create one table so that we can verify whether it's working properly or not. So I'm creating a simple table student, so I'll just complete this command. Okay, so my table has been created. Now I'm just going to describe this table to see the structure of the table. So here I'm going to write a command desk student semicolon. And here you can see it is showing me roll number and name column of my student table. Now I will be inserting one value to this table, a simple value. So I'm inserting roll number as 1 and name as Sunita by using insert into student values command. Okay, and here you can see it's showing me message one row created. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to just type one more command, select star from student. So you can see it's showing me my record of my table. So we installed Oracle, also we type few query. Few more important point I would like to tell you. So by default it is taking a default database. So default database is mounted over here. You can mount or unmount databases whichever you want. So let me just tell you the syntax for mounting or unmounting the databases, and after that I will be showing you how to connect to Enterprise Manager. So I have started one more SQL plus, and here I'm going to login as sysdba so that I can type a administrative command. Okay, so I'm just writing sys as sysdba, and password will remain same whichever you have given during installation. So you can see it is showing me connected to Oracle Database 21c. Now here I will type startup, and you can see it's showing me message that cannot start already running Oracle. So first of all we need to stop the database which are already running. So for that you need to just write a command shutdown. So it is showing me database close and database mounted, and then I can again write a startup command for starting my database. So just it is showing me, okay, so here it is showing me different information of my database like global area, fixed size, variable size and other details also it is showing. Okay, it will return SQL prompt soon. It takes a little time, so it will return soon. Now I have taken screenshot of different connection information, and now I am going to use this Enterprise Manager connection information for connecting to Enterprise Manager. So you can go to browser and you can just type that information. So I'm typing https://5500/em, and now here it's showing me this information that the connection is not private. So it's okay, it is not going to harm. So just click on proceed to localhost. It will not harm your system. You can click on this link, proceed to localhost. Okay, here it's showing me Enterprise Manager login, Oracle Enterprise Manager login. So you need to provide username and password, same credential you can use, sys or system, and the password which you set during installation. Just provide that detail and click on login button. Okay, so now you can see it has taken me to this page, and this is what nothing but different information of your databases, information which are shown by Enterprise Manager Database Express. Okay, that is how we install Oracle Database 21c on Windows machine. Hope you find this video helpful. If yes, please hit the like button and comment and tell me which part of my video you like the most. Also, don't forget to subscribe. And guys, if you have any kind of query, you can put in comment box. I will surely reply to your queries. And also, you can follow me on, the handler is given. Okay. So, thank you guys for watching my video till end. I'll see you in my next video. Till that, bye-bye and take care.